Hello everyone, welcome to the Makri Virtual. Hope you are doing good. Today I am going to continue with your same module, that is the business skills for e-commerce. In the last class we have talked about, or we have finished with the chapter number 1, that is the introduction to e-commerce. Today I am going to start with the new topic, new chapter, that is the chapter number 2. That is framework of e-commerce. So let's take a quick review what we have covered in last class, then move to the chapter number 2, that is framework, that means the structure of e-commerce. So let's start with the previous class session. In the last class we have studied about the limitations of e-commerce, that is what are the limitations that we follow on the e-commerce. So in the last class we have discussed about the limitations of e-commerce, that is the continuation of the last to last class. One of the most important limitation is that no encouragement from business community. That is, there is no encouragement part from the business community. That is, there is no encouragement of e-commerce, of doing the e-commerce from the business community. Everything is going the same way, same procedure, everything is same. But there is no encouragement from business activity. That means it is a business community that sustains e-commerce and greatly influences the thinking and adoption process of various segments of the society to move forward in the field of information technology. That is, it must be encouragement from the business community. Then next point says preferring foreign site. This is also one of the limitation. That's mostly Indian customers or mostly Indian peoples mostly prefer the outsiders website, that is a foreign website, because they think that they provides a great opportunity or they provides a better benefits to their to them, because they think that they prefer that's why they prefer the foreign sites. So this is one of the, again, the limitation, that mostly people, mostly Indian people prefers the foreign sites. So there is no capability or there is no requirement for the Indian sites. So this is also captures the market for the e-commerce, that is, there is no e-commerce from the India only, because most of the people preferring the foreign sites for dealing with the commercial transactions. Next is inactive Indian software houses. That is, this is again the limitation, that is, software houses are not devoted to ensuring store expertise in supply chain and the distribution management solution. That is, the business partners particularly in India are also not devoted to the ensure the strong expertise in the supply chain management and the distribution chain management. That is, efforts must be a lacking stage, or must be on the lacking stage, to ensure the working of the development of system. That means this is also a lacking part. This is one of the limitation of e-commerce, that there should be a, or there have been a inactive Indian software houses in India. Then why? Because this is why it is inactive, because in today's world, or in the last time, or in the previous time, traditional world, most of the people prefer to do the transactions by going into the manually, not choosing the online transactions. Then the next limitation is cyber competition, that there is a cyber competition also that is used, or that is used to deliver the, or that is used to enough to support the cyber growth. Then it is very difficult to re-engineering the products. That is, the products must not, or is not reconfigured or not re-engineering. It is very difficult to re-engineering the products. That is also the limitation. This says the web business structure will have to undergo a drastic change and re-engineering. It is not just also having a website, or about seeking a web address on conventional advertisement, or transferring a few people to new division and destination. So it is very difficult to reconfigure the people, reconfigure the, or re-engineering the products when this product is one time fails. Then next is internet for small businesses. That is another problem that is facing the e-commerce, that a large consumer product company needs a profiling of customer who undertake transactions through e-commerce. That is, e-commerce is still being dominated by the large corporations. Then next is blocking and censorship. Sometime in most of the companies, there are some sites, there are commercial sites that is blocked for the people, for their employees, for their citizens. Why? Because they think that they do the unauthorized activity or they do the cheap activity over the internet. So there should be a, or this is again the limitation that there is a site that is blocked by the government organizations for their citizens. So this is again the limitation. If the site is not available, so how consumer can use them? How consumer can deal with the transactions? In the same way, there is a censorship that is some is it, or they are, or some governments plan a or ban a on the internet or control the access traffic or installing the filters to access the website. That is, there are some websites that is not accessed by all the people. There are traffic mechanism, there are filters that is available on the internet. Next limitation is infant stages. E-commerce is still in the infant state. That is, it is still slow. It is in the infant stage. Indian e-commerce is establishing itself in the area of the internet business. That is, nowadays commerce is, or Indian commerce is only establishing in the area of a internet business. But the concept of e-commerce is still in the evolutionary stage or still in the revolving stage. It is a job that still need to be defined. E-commerce has yet to take off in India because the Indian consumers are way of leaving their credit card number on the internet. That is, e-commerce is again or yet to be take off in India. Why? Because it is not applicable in India, because most of the people don't prefer to share their credit card number, account number, PAN number and so on, the personal information. They are not ready to provide that information over the internet. Now the next part is summary. That is the last part. We have also covered about the summary. That is, what is e-commerce, what we have covered in this chapter. So e-commerce is nothing but the commerce that is doing the transactions online. That is, whenever we do the transactions electronically, that means the e-commerce. Customers are still customers and merchants wants people there at their end. They send confidential, personal, financial information only by the email or can cash on the phone or might just prefer to visit in person. Next line also says it is only a new way of doing the business or additional way of doing the business. It is a new generation technology, new method, business with new generation technology. Still there are many drawbacks that is available, that is the technical limitations and the non-technical limitations. So this is a summary. This is one of the important line. It is viewed, that is, e-commerce is to be viewed as a business, not as a technology issue. Then we have also talked about the keywords. That is, what are the keywords that is available? One is the e-commerce. E-commerce means electronic commerce, that is digitally enabled commercial transactions between and among organizations and individual. That is, there is a digital compute or digitally enabled commercial transaction that is performed between the organization and the individuals. Then next is EDI, that is an electronic data interchange. That is also a new way to exchange the data. So whenever there is a requirement to exchange the data over the internet, that is provided by the EDI, that is electronic data interchange. Then the next category is B2B, that is a business to business e-commerce that takes place between the business to business transactions. So these are the various levels that we have studied. Then B2C, then that is business to consumer, that means one business is dealing with another customer. Then C2C, that is consumer to consumer. Then B2E, that is business to employee e-commerce. Then C2B, that is consumer to business e-commerce. So these are the various levels of business that we have studied in this chapter. Then there is a C2B, that is consumer to business e-commerce. Then there is a cyber law, that is a law which is used to deal with all cyber crimes. That is the crime that is done on the internet. Now the next part is the self-assessment questions. That is a self-assessment questions. So these are the various questions that we have discussed in the last class. What is e-commerce, limitations, features, or scenario based question, or the statement based questions. These are the various references book. Now chapter number 2, this is the today's topic. Let's start with the today's topic, that is the framework of e-commerce. Let's start with chapter number 2, that is a framework of e-commerce. Now, what is the structure, means what are the content that is available in this chapter? These are the various contents like objective, what is the objective of e-commerce? Then introduction, then information providers, then e-commerce functions. E-commerce a generic framework, it is a generic framework. Then e-commerce building blocks, means what are the building blocks of e-commerce, that is the object and the classes. Then e-compatible legal and financial frameworks, that is an Indian approach. Then summary, then keywords, then self-assessment questions, then suggested readings. So these are the 10 topics in this chapter. So let's start with the objectives, that is the first chapter. This says electronic commerce, a new means of carrying out business transaction through electronic mean, that is electronically in general, and to internet environment in particularly, has been providing or proving its potential benefits and effective contribution to the socio-economic growth. That is electronic commerce, it is a new means of carrying out the business transactions. So it is a new means to carry out the transactions, or it is a new mean to carry out the business transactions that is used so it is a new means to carry out the transactions business transactions through electronic means in general and through internet environment in particular has been proving its potential benefits. That is, there are so many potential benefits that is available over the internet for doing the transactions. So this provides a potential benefits or proving its potential benefits and effective contribution to the socio-economic growth. As an essential part of digital economy, electronic commerce plays the role as a key for us to open our door to the 21st century. That is, it is an essential part of the digital economy. So it is an essential part of the digital economy. Electronic commerce plays the role as the key for us to open our door to the 21st century. That is, everything is doing online. That is, every transaction is doing online. So it is a better improvement in the e-commerce. So it is a better improvement for doing the business electronically. The new era of knowledge-based economy. So this is the objective, that is the e-commerce advantages. In simple terms, e-commerce benefits, that is, what are the benefits of e-commerce? So everything is doing online, so this provides a great impact on the growth of the economy, growth of the country, that is a socio-economic growth. So as an essential part of digital economy, electronic commerce plays the role as a key for us to open our door to the 21st century, that is the new era of knowledge-based economy. In the context of electronic commerce, there is a need to define the framework of e-commerce. That is, in the context of e-commerce, there is a need to define the framework. So there is a need or there is a requirement to define the framework of the e-commerce. After doing through this lesson, so this is the objective of this chapter. That is, what is the objective, how we can deal this. So whenever we use the e-commerce, whenever we say about the e-commerce, that means the commerce with the help of the electronically, or commerce that is done electronically, that is also the framework, or that is also there is a need to go through the framework of the e-commerce. Then after going to this lesson, you will be able to describe the framework of e-commerce. That is, after going through this lesson, after going through this part, let us these are the concepts that you are able to understand. First of all, describes the concept of or framework of e-commerce. Then illustrates different building blocks of e-commerce. That is, what are the different building blocks, how we can choose the e-commerce, or what are the different building blocks that is available for the e-commerce. Then identify the various functions of e-commerce. That is, what are the various functions of e-commerce, or identify the various parts or the functions of e-commerce. Then explain the Indian approach of legal and financial framework of e-commerce. that is, what are the approach or what are the Indian approach of the legal and the financial framework of e-commerce. So these are the four lessons that is that we will be able to understand after this lesson. So first of all, describe the framework, then illustrate different building blocks, then identify the various functions, then explain the Indian approach of legal and financial framework. Now first is or first topic is introduction, that is 2.1, that is introduction of the e-commerce. So this says e-commerce is the ability to perform transactions involving the exchange of goods and services between two or more parties using electronic tools and techniques. So e-commerce is the ability to perform transactions, or it is the ability to do the transactions that involves the exchange of goods and services, that is exchanging of goods and services between two or more parties using electronic tools and techniques, that is using electronic media, using electronically in e-commerce is used, or e-commerce is doing the transaction, that is the commerce of the transaction, that is the use the commerce of transaction, that is the buying and selling of transactions, buying and selling of goods and services over the internet between two or more parties using electronic tools and techniques. Long employed by large businesses and financial service organizations, several factors are now converging to bring electronic commerce to a new level of utility and viability for small businesses and individuals. So this says long employed by large businesses, that is the long employed means long employed by large businesses, long usage by large businesses and financial service organizations, several factors are now involving or converging to bring e-commerce to a new level of utility, that brings to the new level of utility and viability for small business and individuals, thereby promising to make it part of everyday life, that is it becomes a part of the everyday life, that is doing the transactions over the internet. These enabling factors include improved broader competitive access to networks, reduced cost and increased user friendliness of both general purpose computers and specialized devices. That is these factors, that is electronic tool, electronic development, exchange of goods and services, reducing the cost. So these enabling factors include improved broader competitive access to network and reduce the cost and increase the user friendliness of both general purpose computers and specialized devices. The rapid growth of primarily the internet and other online services, convenient point of sale payment system and automated teller machines all sets the stage for broad scale electronic commerce. So the rapid growth of the internet and other online services, that is available, convenient point of sale payment system, that is a POS, that is a post payment system, we swipe the card, there is a payment that is available. So these are the various growth that is available that also affects the e-commerce. So the rapid growth of primarily the internet and other online services, convenient point of sale system and automatic teller machine, that is the ATM, all sets the stage for broad scale electronic commerce. So these are the various techniques, or these are the various growth that is available for the various businesses for broad scale electronic commerce. Further, with relentless pressures of competition at all levels of the economy, the efficiencies offered by electronic commerce are becoming hard to ignore. That is, with the pressure of competition that is available in the economy, the efficiencies that is offered by e-commerce are becoming hard to ignore. Then 2.2 is information providers. That is, who are the information providers that is used? Traditionally, in the physical world, we distinguish between three types of information-driven companies. That is, traditionally, or who are the information providers for the e-commerce? Traditionally means, in the past time, in the physical world, we differentiate between three types of, or three different types of information-driven companies. Those that create the companies, create the content, for example, TV production. Those that defines the form or format, for example, recording studio. And finally, those that provides the distribution media, medium, the example TV broadcasting station and cable operators. So whenever we say about the information providers, so in the past days everything is doing offline. That is, traditionally in the physical world we differentiate between three types of information driven companies. What are the three types? First one, those who create the content, that is manufacture the content, example TV production. Those that defines the form or format, example recording studio. Next, those who provides the distribution medium, example TV broadcasting station and cable operators. So these are the three providers. These are the three information driven companies that is used that provides the information about the electronic tool. Companies that are targeting vertical markets need access in all the three areas. One is distribution, then form, then content. That is types of information providers. One who distribute, one who forms, one who made the contents. So this is the information providers. Now, next is e-commerce functions. That is, what are the functions that is available for the e-commerce? So the following 10 functions must be provided in order to EC2 occur. In a sense that they are the enablers of EC. First one says, or first function says of e-commerce is standard setting body. That is, there must be a, or there should be a standard setting body for e-commerce. That is, there is only one body that is available for e-commerce. That is a standard setting body. There is no that one site follows another body, another site follow other rules regulation, another site follows another protocols rules regulation. No, that is not that does not give the good impact. So there must be a standard setting body. There must be a standard body that is available for the rules regulation, diplomatic policies, any policy that is used. Then next point says WAN service providers. What is a WAN? That is a wide area network. So e-commerce function, important function is WAN service providers. That is, it is available in wide area. That is, a WAN service providers means it is available in WAN areas. That is, it is available globally. That is, people sitting at the vertical location, people sitting at the distance location or distant location, they can communicate with each other. They can use the services from each other with the help of WAN. Then next is hosting services. That is, a data center. This is again the function that the data center is also available for enabling the, or for using the e-commerce. Then software developer, then certification authority, then publisher, aggregator, that is a presence provider, then copyright broker, meeting authority, then auditing and authoring, who does the auditing, information consumer, that is a consumers. The provisions of the above 10 e-commerce function does not necessitate the involvement of an equipment number of parties. That is, whenever we talk about these e-commerce function, that does not mean that we required all the parties. Many of these will be carried out by the same provider. That is, there is no thing that if there are 10 functions, so 10 providers are needed. No, only one function or all the 10 functions are provided by single source or single company or single party. But many of these will be carried out by the same provider. Not all, but many of these will be provided by the same information provider. For example, the hosting services can be the same organization as the publisher or aggregator. So it must be a same, it must be a different. It depends on the scenario to scenario, system to system. Then next is next topic is e-commerce. That is, the electronic commerce, a generic framework. So the electronic commerce agentic framework, that is what is the framework or what is the structure of the e-commerce. As we have discussed in chapter number 1, that e-commerce is related to execution of business transactions of electronic message devices. That is, e-commerce is nothing but the execution of business transactions. That is, execution means involving the business transaction, that is dealing with the business transaction, that is executing with the business transactions for electronic media devices, electronic message devices. That means everything is doing online. Even the transactions, the commerce is doing the online. So e-commerce is related to execution of business transactions of electronic messaging devices. There have been a lot of changes in the traditional business model to incorporate advantages offered by e-commerce. That is, whatever is covered or whatever we have done in the past days, that is, everything is doing offline. In most of the cases, even shopping is doing by going to the houses or by going to the shops. But nowadays, most of the things are offered by the e-commerce or are offered on the online. That is, the commerce is done online. So that is a generic framework. The old brick and mortar businesses are finding way to incorporate the activities to gain from the avenues opened by e-commerce. That is the prior system, that is a back and mortar system. That is also a way to incorporate the activities to gain advantages from the avenues opened by e-commerce. While on the other hand, there is a swarm of new entrepreneurs in race to establish themselves in the new digital marketplace. The old businesses, that is the old business, that is the brick and mortar businesses, are the finding ways to incorporate the activities to gain the advantages from the avenues that is opened by the e-commerce. So there must be advantageous factor that is used to use the new digital marketplace. But like in real physical markets, only those will survive that have a strong fundamental framework that is based on sound business and market understanding. That is, everything is doing correct, but the main concern is that every business must have a strong framework so that it must survive in the market. It must survive in the entrepreneur market. So this says, but like in real physical market, only those will survive which have a strong fundamental framework that is based on sound business and market understanding. That only those businesses will survive that have a strong business, that have a sound business and the market understanding. As e-commerce is rather in its nascent stage and is evolving at a fast pace, the importance of developing business models on such sound framework is accentuated. That is, as e-commerce is doing or is rather in the stage and is evolving at a fast pace, that is, e-commerce is doing at a fast pace or going for a fast pace, the importance of doing the business models, that is, importance of developing the business models, that is, different business models like B2B, B2C, C2C, C2B, the importance of developing the business models on such frameworks is accentuated or needed or required. Such a framework needs to encompass within the itself the basic and supportive infrastructure and business applications, as well as the basic issues that are needed to be kept in mind while developing the e-commerce business model. So such a framework, that is the e-commerce framework, that is needed for carrying out the basic needs, for carrying out the basic ideas that is used for developing the e-commerce business models. There are certain basic consideration that should be kept in mind while developing a generic framework for e-commerce. That is, these are the various criteria or these are the various contents that must be kept in mind or that must follow while developing a generic framework for e-commerce, or that must be used while developing a generic framework for e-commerce. So what are the basic consideration that should be kept in mind? First is interoperability. That is, e-commerce must be based on a common set of services and standards that ensures interoperability. So e-commerce must be or e-commerce that is used that must be on the based on or based on a common set of services and standards that ensures interoperability. Preferably, service providers and application designers will be able to use these services. That is preferably means most of the cases service providers and application designers will be able to use these services and standards as building blocks that can be combined, enhanced and customized. That is these are the designers that is used for using the building blocks for developing the building blocks that can be combined, enhanced and customized. So this is interoperability. Next is flexibility and forward integration. I'm just coming within 2 minutes. So e-commerce must be based on some common set of standards, services that ensure the interoperability. That is, e-commerce must follow some rules and regulations, policies, protocols for to ensure the interoperability. That is, they can operate in a proper manner, they can operate in an easy manner. That is the interoperability. Preferably, service providers and application designers will be able to use these services and standards as building blocks that can be combined, enhanced and customized. That is, service providers and application designers will be able to use these services and standards as a building blocks that can be combined, enhanced and customized. The next is flexibility and forward integration. This is the next point. That is there is a flexibility and the forward integration among the e-commerce. So e-commerce, as said above, is still in its nascent stage and is constantly improving. That is, e-commerce is still in the stage, is still in the stage that is used to be grown or that is used for the growing purpose. So it is a stage or it is still in the nascent stage that must be or that needs to be constantly improves the or improved. That is the stage, and as it does so, new services and business application areas will emerge. For doing the or for improving the qualities of the e-commerce, new services and the business application areas will emerge. It is therefore very much logical than any generic framework developed for e-commerce. That is, it is much logical than the generic framework that is available or that is developed for the e-commerce that shall be able to accommodate future enhancement and trends in infrastructure, industry and application. So these are the various framework or these are the various consideration while doing the framework that e-commerce must be flexible. That is, it is available all the time. That is 24/7. That is the flexibility. So sorry. And forward integration. That is, there must be a forward integration that we can integrate any part of e-commerce at any time. This is also a flexibility. That is, we can use any part at any time. So there should be a flexible conditions at every time. Then next third point says involving latest technology and application. So whenever we develop the framework for e-commerce, it must be kept in mind that there or this or that e-commerce functions or that e-commerce structure must involve the latest technology and the applications. As the technologies logical and business logic develops in its natural flow during the evolution of e-commerce, the e-commerce framework should be able to incorporate those newer technology and business logics. So as the technology and the business logic develops in its natural flow, natural way during the evolution of e-commerce, so the e-commerce framework should be able to incorporate those new technology and the business logics. An example of such possible business logic will be the payment system. That is the payment system of the e-commerce, either doing the transactions online or payment is done online. That will be the payment system that is available or that should be developed along the path of development in the field of path of development of the field. The generic framework of e-commerce should be able to acknowledge and accept such advancement, especially in the field of electronic payment system. So the generic framework of e-commerce should be able to acknowledge or should be able to take off and accept such advancement, especially in the field of electronic payment system. Especially in the electronic payment system, there is an enhancement that is used for the e-commerce. Next is backward integration. Next consideration that is taken while doing the or while creating the framework. Next is backward integration. There will be many business enterprises that will shift from traditional e-commerce to the electronic e-commerce. There will be many business enterprises, that is, there are so many enterprises that is available that will shift from traditional commerce, that is offline commerce, to the online commerce, that is electronic commerce. These traditional business enterprises are bound to using their own legacy system. That is, in the previous time, or at the previous time, there are offline businesses, that is, there are the traditional business enterprises that use their own legacy system. They include legacy system includes the paper pen, paper checks, mainframe based settlement, payment system, EDI vans, that is electronic data interchange vans. So these are the various issues, or these are the various criteria that is used in the legacy system. That includes the paper checks, mainframe based settlement, payment system, EDI vans, etc. It is very much logical to expect that these legacy system will not vanish overnight. That is, this system not vanish overnight, as they can, or they are following the case of the EDI, or they are following the case of the legacy system. A successful electronic commerce infrastructure must let the user transfer easily and transparently. So when we talk about the electronic commerce, that is the e-commerce infrastructure, that must let the user interface or user transfer easily. That is, user can transfer the things or user can move the things easily and transparently, so that everyone knows, yeah, where is the good, this is the good that is used, or this is the product that is used. That must let the user transfer easily and transparently between these older system and newer system, all electronic system, applications and processes. So this is a backward integration, that there must be a backward integration, transfer policies, transfer rules between the older system and the newer one, all electronic system, applications and processes. So there must be a backward integration, there must be an integration among the various parts of the customers, among the various parts of the, among various products, among various applications, among various processes. That is a backward integration. Now the next is media convergence. So this is the fifth point, that is the media convergence. That is, electronic commerce transactions will involve all kinds of legacy and newly developed devices. That e-commerce transactions will involve, or it involves, all kinds of legacy systems and newly developed devices. That is, whenever we talk about the e-commerce transaction, that is a transaction that is done online, that involves all kinds of legacy and newly developed devices and media and networks that is used or that is delivered whenever we use the e-commerce. So e-commerce transactions will involve all kinds of legacy and newly developed devices and media and networks over which these are delivered. A generic framework developed for e-commerce must be able to take into its stride the ability to accommodate the plethora of technology. That is, a generic framework that is developed for e-commerce must be used or must be taken into consideration to accommodate the technologies, devices, their convergence needed to reach and sustain the mass market. That is, needed to reach the and sustain the mass market that is available for the media convergence. So this is the media convergence, that is, we can doing the transactions online, that is, we are doing the benefits online, that is used for the legacy system, that is used for the delivery system. That is, the e-commerce transactions will involve all kinds of legacy, newly developed devices and media network over which these are delivered. That is the media convergence. Now next is sixth one, that is information intensive products. That is the sixth point, that is the information intensive products. So let's take a break right now, then move to this topic, move to this consideration that is follow while doing the e-commerce framework or while building the e-commerce framework. So let's stop over here only and take a break, then move to 6-1, that is information intensive products. So let's take a break. Hello, 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 hello. Yeah, come back from the break. So let's continue the session again. So the next consideration that is taken upon when we use the technology or when we use the business technology, when we use the or design the framework for the e-commerce. Let's take the next one, that is the 6-1 technology, 6-1 consideration that is followed. 6-1 says information intensive products. That is an information intensive product, that is the next technology or the next framework or the next consideration that it follows while doing the transactions over the e-commerce. This says a particularly important class of products on NII, that is the National Institutions, are those that are pure information. That is a national or the important class of product that is used. If the product information is the usage information that is used, that is a pure information that is available over there. So these products are actually enabled by information technology and not just distributed more effectively by it. That is the product that is available, that is the information intensive product that is available for the pure information. These products are actually enabled by information technology, not just distributed more efficiently by it. That is, these products are actually enabled by the IT. That is a product that is available, that is used by the, or that is used for, enabled by the computer, that is the IT, not just distributed more efficiently by it. Information products includes electronic publications, catalogs, videos and the like, as well as interactive video games. So the information products includes the electronic publications. That is the information product that is available, that includes public electronic publications, catalogs, videos and the like, as well as interactive video games, software programs, electronic tokens, customized design specification and even electronic keys to hotel rooms, cars, storage compartments, airports, boarding gates. So these are the various products that is used while doing the transactions over the internet. What are the terms or what are the products that is including or that includes? So that includes the electronic publications, catalogs, videos, interactive video games, software programs, electronic tokens, customized design specifications, and even electronic keys. That is electronic way to for the hotel room. That is, if I punch the room, if I punch with the key, a room will be opened. That is the electronic key to the hotel rooms, cars, storage compartments, airport boarding gates, etc. Many of these products will not be simply offered by a vendor. That is, many of the products or many of these products will not be simply offered by the vendor. They will be designed or tailored by a customer. That is, many of these products will not simply offered or simply used by the or simply getting by the vendor, but they will be designed or tailored by a customer. Customer can, for example, choose their own selection of articles to be bound in an electronic book. That is, customer, for example, or customer can, for example, choose their own selection of articles, choose their own selection of articles to be used in the electronic book, to be used in the electronic way, electronic media, or customize their clothing designs. That is, if they use their own selection, they use their own criteria that is used in the electronic book or customize their own clothing designs. This capability adds a customer-driven activity, that is a design phase, to the purchase cycle. So this capability adds a customer-based driven activity that is used, that is designed to purchase or to be used as a purchase cycle. It is likely that for these products, ordering, billing, payment and distribution will be tightly integrated and happens virtually simultaneously. That is, for these products, what are the products? That is, ordering, billing, payment, distribution will be tightly integrated and happens virtually simultaneously. That is, while doing the transactions over the internet, that is developing the framework, that is the structure of e-commerce. Proper method or proper way is to be used on the products, ordering, billing, payment, and distribution that will be integrated and happens virtually simultaneously. Next is new revenue collection methods. That is the next consideration, that is the revenue collection methods. That is the usage of the new revenue collection methods. That is the electronic commerce will need to support advanced type of revenue collection in addition to the traditional methods. That is the e-commerce will need or will use to support the advanced type of revenue collections. That is whenever we use the e-commerce. That is transactions over the internet. So they support the advanced type of revenue collection. That is the revenue means the profits collection in the advanced manner in addition to the traditional methods like payment upon receipt, payment in advance, etc. For example, an information product service provider could distribute its products widely and charge on a usage basis. That is information product provider could distribute the products widely and charge on a usage basis. That is charge the customer only when the information is used. That is charge the customer whenever or only when the information is used. That may be a software program. What is the information? That may be a software program, that may be a digital document, that may be electronic key, that open and start or enter car is used. That is either it may be electronic key, digital document, digital certificate, software program, that is used as the information that is charged by the consumer. That is the use or that is charged the consumer only when the information is used. One innovative approach that permits usage accounting and payment is known as meterware. That is the one approach that is used, one innovative approach that permits or that is used for accounting and the payment is known as meterware. It provides local hardware and or software to record and bill customers continuously based on their product usage. That is, it provides means the e-commerce also provides local hardware or software to record and bill customers continuously based on their product usage. Meterware, electronic cash and checks that don't need an online payment processor and other advanced revenue collection ideas create opportunities for reaching new customers and for distributing products and services. That is, electronic cash and checks that don't need an online payment processor, other revenue collection ideas creates opportunity for reaching new customers and distributing products and services. These methods makes a lot of sense in a low distribution cost environment supported by an electronic commerce infrastructure. That is the method that is used like payment upon receipt or bill customers, digital document, electronic key that is used or that makes a lot of sense in a low distribution cost that is provided or that is supported by the electronic commerce infrastructure that is used for the low distribution cost. Now the next is eighth one is legacy systems. That is the legacy system is used, that is the offline system is used. This point says many legacy systems exist in the electronic commerce domain. That is nowadays also most of the legacy system that is used that exist in the electronic commerce domain. In other domains in e-trading, e-commerce, e-shipping, there's nothing but mostly cases legacy system exists in the e-commerce domain. This includes or these includes that the legacy systems includes paper checks, mainframe based settlement, payment systems, EDI vans. These are the various legacy system issues that is available with the e-commerce. None of these legacy systems will go away overnight. A successful electronic commerce infrastructure must let the user transfer easily and transparently between these older systems and newer systems, all electronic systems, applications and processes. that is a successful electronic commerce infrastructure is used or must let the user transfer easily and transparently between the older system and the new system. That is done electronically. That is used electronically. That is the electronic systems, applications and processes. That is a legacy system. That is nowadays also the legacy system must exist in the electronic commerce domain. Now the next one is transaction devices. That is the ninth point. That is also must be consideration, that also take into consideration while doing the transactions over the internet. That is the transaction devices. That is e-commerce transactions will involve all kinds of legacy and newly developed devices and media. That is whenever we use the e-commerce, that is the e-commerce transactions that involves the legacy system. Legacy system means the payment over the internet or the paper pen, usage of paper, cost. So e-commerce transactions will involve all kinds of legacy and newly developed devices and media and network over which they are or these are delivered. Electronic commerce must accommodate the technologies and devices that is needed to reach and sustain the mass market. That is e-commerce must accommodate the technology, must use the technologies and devices that is needed to reach and sustain the mass market. That is used or that is needed to reach and sustain the mass market that is available. A framework developed with all of these needs and considerations in mind will form the strongest basis for a powerful and useful electronic commerce infrastructure. That is a framework that is developed with all of these needs and consideration that is in mind will form the strongest basis for a powerful and useful electronic commerce infrastructure that is used. So these are the various needs and these are the various considerations that we follow while doing the transactions or while developing the e-commerce framework. So these are the total nine consideration that must be followed. This says there are certain basic considerations that must be kept in mind. These are total nine consideration. First one is your interoperability, flexibility, better technology, that is the latest technology, backward integration, media convergence, information intensive products, new revenue collection methods, legacy systems, transaction devices. A framework developed with all of these needs and consideration. So whenever we develop a framework for e-commerce with including every consideration above considerations in mind will form the strongest basis for a powerful and useful e-commerce infrastructure. That is will form the strongest or will form the strongest basis or will form the strongest part of a for a powerful and useful electronic commerce infrastructure. So sorry. We now describe the specific activities and functions that this infrastructure must support. That is, first of all, take into consideration all the features, then uses the e-commerce infrastructure, then uses the infrastructure that is used for the powerful and useful electronic commerce infrastructure. So we next describe the specific activities and function this infrastructure must support. So next is these are the various activities and these are the various functions that is used. So what are the activities and the functions that must be consideration or that must be taken off while doing the or while creating the transactions or while creating the infrastructure over the or while creating the framework for the e-commerce. The first activities and functions, the first one is advertising and shopping. That is the first activity that is used, that is the advertising and shopping, then negotiating, then ordering, then billing. So these are the various activities and functions that is used for the consideration of the e-commerce. That is advertising or advertising, shopping, negotiating, ordering, billing, payment and settlement, distribution and receipt, accounting, customer service, information and knowledge processing. So these are the various activities and functions that must be followed while developing the framework for the e-commerce, while using the framework for the e-commerce. So these are the various activities and functions that is used. The specific functions associated with these activities in an electronic commerce setting as discussed below. That is, what are the functions that that is the what is the functionality of these activities? What are the activities? Advertising, shopping, negotiating, ordering, billing, payment, distribution, receipt. So these are the various activities. Now let's see what is the function of each activity that is available. That is, what is the role of billing? What is the role of payment system? What is the role of settlement system? What is the role of advertising, shopping? These are the various activities that must be consideration in the e-commerce framework, and what are the functionality of each activity. Now let's see the specific functions associated with these activities in an electronic commerce setting are discussed below. Note that not all of these activities are performed in every transaction, nor are they necessary performed in this order. Indeed, they may be performed in parallel. Also, all activities are not necessary conducted electronically. That is, all activities are not doing or not necessary conducted electronically. Finally, these activities can vary in complexity and importance depending on the transaction size and scope. That is, finally, these activities can vary in the complexity or can vary in complexity and importance depending on the transaction size and scope. So it depends on the size of the e-commerce, it depends on the longitude, or it depends on the widespread of the e-commerce these functions or these activities is used, that is advertisement, payment, settlement. It depends on the requirement to requirement. So first is let's talk about this activity, that is the advertising and shopping. Let's talk about this first one, that is how e-commerce can be developed or how e-commerce framework will be developed on the basis of this one. What are the functionalities that involve in this activity? This activity can include, that is the advertising and shopping activity will include. First point says searching and browsing electronic directories and catalogs on the network. That is, whenever we use the networking, so whenever we use the advertising, we can send and browse. That is, we can send anything, we can browse electronic directories, catalogs on a network. That is the advertising and shopping. Next is enabling intelligent agents for various purposes on behalf of one or many users, buyers or sellers. That is, this activity also enables or also includes the intelligent agents for various purposes on behalf of one or more buyers or customers. That is, it enables the intelligent agents for using or for these purposes on behalf of various buyers and sellers. The next point says buyer sending electronic request for proposals. That is the RPF. That is a request for proposals. That is, buyers also send electronic requests for proposals and sellers responding with various offers. That is, buyers also send the electronic request that is used for the electronic request for proposal, that is RPF, and sellers responding with various offers. So this activity includes this one, that is the from advertising and shopping. Seller advertising their products, that is who is the seller who wants to sell their products. The seller makes an effort to advertise their products either with the electronically or with the offline, either distributing the pamphlets or either making the pop-up on the email sites or either pop-up on the websites. So seller advertise or advertising their products and services to market their products, to explore their products, to increase the quality of their products, to get the better revenue from their product. देन लास्ट वन सेज इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली नेविगेटिंग नेटवर्क एक्सेसिबल सर्विसेज, दैट इज दे आर नेटवर्कली और इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली नेविगेटिंग, और दे आर इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली नेविगेट, और देर मस्ट बी इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली नेविगेशन फ्रॉम नेटवर्क एक्सेसिबल सर्विसेज। A major problem associating with the advertising and shopping activities is the cost and the time that is expended in developing, maintaining, and finding relevant information, product, and services. The major problem with the advertising or shopping activity is the cost and time, that there must be a excessive cost and there must be excessive time that is required for developing, maintaining, and finding relevant information about the product and services. That is, this is a major problem that is available, that is high cost, high time, that is there is a high cost that is used, there is a high time or more time that is used in developing, maintaining, and finding relevant information, product and services, given the plentitude of available information. Obviously, this problem will become increasingly complex as more data and services become available online. So obviously, this problem will become increasingly complex as more data and services become available online, and choices and possibilities multiply exponentially. That is, there must be increase, or there must be an online transaction that must be increased, and the choices and the possibilities are increased or multiply exponentially. We need better ways to find and offer services and products. So this is also the limitation, this is also a drawback, this is also a problem that is associated with the advertising and shopping. What is the problem? That is the cost and the time that is required in developing, maintaining, and finding relevant. Now, the next activity is negotiating, that is a negotiation among the buyers and sellers. Negotiation means the bargaining of the in terms of the cost, in terms of anything, that is a bargaining among the buyers and sellers. So this is, buyers and sellers may elect to negotiate the terms of a transactions. That is, the buyers and sellers may elect or may use to negotiate the terms of a transaction. They negotiate about the transaction, that is the terms of exchange and payment. That is the terms of exchange and payment that is required, that is a that is doing the buyer and seller to negotiate the terms of a transaction. These terms may cover delivery, refund policies, arranging for credit, installment payments, copyright, license agreement, usage rights, distribution rights, etc. So whenever there is a negotiation among the buyers and seller, that is in terms of exchange and payment, either they can do the or either they can do the negotiation in terms of exchange, or either they can do the negotiation in terms of payment. That is that includes delivery, refund policies, arranging from credit or arranging from for credit, installment payments, copyright or licensing agreements, usage rights, distribution rights, etc. These terms can be standardized for routine commodity used or customized to suit more unique individual situations. That is, that these terms can be standardized or can be used for the routine commodity used or customized to suit more unique individual conditions or situations. Often, in the case of two parties with a well-established business relationship, that is, in the case of two parties, whenever there are two parties, that is buyer and seller, with a well-established business relationship, the term of exchange are pre-negotiated. So whenever there is a buyer and seller, so it must be used that in the case of two parties with a well-established business relationship, the terms of exchange are pre-negotiated as standing contractual terms for all their future exchanges. That is, it uses the contextual term, it uses the establish the business relationship as the standing contractual term for their future exchanges. This process will frequently also include the authentication of two parties. That is, this process will increase or frequently includes the authentication of two parties that is used, that is the negotiating the terms of contacts. Next is ordering. That is the next part. That is, what is the ordering or what is the functionality of ordering in this one? So I will take this topic in the next class. So let's stop over here only. That is still negotiating. So we covered two functions. That is two activities, not functions. Two activities. One is advertising and shopping. One is negotiating. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 advertising or activities are left. We wind up this 7 activities in the next class. So we covered only 2 activities and their functionalities in today's class. So let's stop this class over here only. If there is any doubts, you can ask the doubts from me. There is no issue. And don't hesitate to ask the silly questions also. So feel free to ask from me. Thanks a lot, everyone. Bye-bye. So thanks a lot for today's session. Thank you so much.